Part of the truth. This is Pita de Aslan, transmitted from Sacramento, California. Even though we are an endangered species, even though a few folks say that we may not last more than a couple of decades, we hear it like Guy McPherson and others, and even though we're an endangered species, with severe character defects, remember the seven deadly sins, maybe the worst one is greed, G-R-E-E-D. Even though we have a reactionary idiot in the White House, even though we have an apathetic, dumbed-down general population that has Nazi tendencies when we think in terms of MAGA, Make America Great Again, which is a form of Nazi National Socialism, if you know your history. Even though we have all this shit working against us, I still believe we need to try to exhaust all legal, peaceful methods of resistance against tyranny, all legal, peaceful methods of struggle, including using the power of the internet as we have it now, knowing that, say, Google, which is another corporation, can wipe us out with just pushing the button. There's other ways that we can still do. Point is that the truth is going to come out one way or the other, no matter how much they try to suppress or distort it, the truth will come out. You cannot eliminate the truth. You can distort it with propaganda. You can conceal it with fancy words, but the truth comes out in the end. And the truth is that voting is just one way of struggling, including having people's militias on the local level, including having a gun club, including having martial arts classes, teach self-defense skills, including graffiti in the alley. You know, so there's many ways to struggle against empire. And we gotta understand that, we gotta understand reality. Redundant as this may seem, we here in the USA are not a truly independent country. We are internal subjects of empire, E-M-P-I-R-E. We're not truly an independent nation. I want to do what I can to make sure that we do not elect Trump again next election season for president. I myself am an independent voter. I was a Democrat most of my life, and so was my dad. In fact, many of us, we adopt the political party of our parents, of our father. We're in a patriarchy society where the father knows best, and we generally go by the political party of our father. My dad has passed away a while back, and I'm an independent. I am out of the fixation on you're either Democrat or you're Republican. I'm out of the fixation that you're either left or you're right. So truth is in the center. We don't mobilize the forces that we can and do what we can to change reality. Even though we're in trouble now, trust and believe things can get worse. If we do nothing, they will surely get worse. I got my good friend Guile, like Mike Kay, talking about what is to be done. And I think in terms of raising consciousness, trying to reach the people that we can, trying to cultivate a vanguard leadership mentality. Knowing that we're not going to reach everyone, but we do want to reach those who consider themselves as leaders or trendsetters, and have influence on other people, whether through their personal ways, their personality, or through an organization, or through a cultural affiliation. Well, we are the people who are leaders, because we don't need a bunch of blind followers. We don't need any more Nazis. We need people who strive to improve themselves, who are sane, who are sober, and who are dedicated to the liberation of the people. So to help forward our interests, our survival interests, people, they gather together in political parties. Now, next election, who knows, Trump might get it. The way things are going now, unless Mueller gets off his ass and does something. Don't hold your breath. The power of money here in America, where money is God, just to believe, money's God, has powerful leverage against those who seek change, constructive, creative change, and those who oppose change. Those who want things to go on in business as usual. If you look on the global level, A handful of trillionaires control the wealth of the world. It consists of billions of people. Now, of those billions of people, if each of us are thinking that we're just alone, isolated, separated, individual, we don't see at least the potential for a collective revolutionary consciousness, and we're not going to make it. We need to to stop the whole Cold War crap between Russia and the USA. Which any war between Russia and the USA would be man, M-A-D, mutually assured destruction. So, in the long run, we want to create democracy in terms of rule by the majority without tyranny for the minority. A global democracy. Not necessarily democratic socialism, but democratic globalism. We're all on this planet together. And we're going to avoid extinction, which is a real, real possibility. It takes about 20 minutes to last a nuclear war. Could just take an instant just to push the button, the doomsday button. And there's reasons why many people are depressed. We're already repressed mentally. We're told, oh, you're crazy, you know, you better just stick to your job, just, you know, get along, go with the program, and just shut up and eat. Many people do not eat, many people go hungry. If we get our head out of our ass and see that there's some real suffering going on, different ways, mentally, physically, spiritually, there's suffering going on. And I have to have my cataracts done on my eyes. I'm an old fart, I'm 66 earth years. But I see the suffering every day. I live in downtown Sacramento, in a low-income hotel, motel called the Shasta Hotel downtown here, and it's sad, it's too bad, so sad. Yet, I keep on plugging away, I keep on struggling. I keep on fighting back against fascism. I keep on speaking my mind, sharing the truth the way I see it. Not hung up on how many so-called views I get here are what. I need to express myself. If only it's just those bricks on the wall behind me that hears me, so be it. I'm not gonna go down a quiet, passive, silent slave. I hate evil. I'm a recovering new ager. I'm a recovered dopamine. And things are tough. I know that. A good brother here, Dr. Tom Majority, asked me for salt. Salt. S-A-L-T. I give him some salt. People are hurting. And it hurts more when you hold it in. When you don't express yourself, when you don't express your grievance. like the Starman here says, why complain? No one listens anyway. I complain because I can. Have a cheap little tablet here. Hopefully get a video regular camcorder someday. And I will. Because I'm determined. Remember the 3D. 3D. Discipline, direction, and determination. Also remember concentration on the coordination of communication. The 3 C's, concentration and coordination of communication. I got a little acronyms are called. I got like TEA. Time, energy, attention. Our 8. Attention, time, energy. So this has been, see, things like they kind of gradually grow up in my consciousness where I see things, I hear things, and I witness stuff, and then I get these ideas, I get these feelings, I get these thoughts that kind of just circle around in my head. Sometimes they drive me a little crazy. Okay. Crazy-er. So I do my little cheap-ass videos. Whoever watches it, watches it. Whoever doesn't, doesn't. I'm not tripping. I believe in the Creator. When I meet my Maker, I want to know that I did what I could to make it a better world. That's all I'm asking you. Do what you can. You know, some people, they have 8-to-5 jobs and they have children to take care of and a lot to keep happy and I'm kind of a monk. And I have my sanity. My company. Sanity is to me basically using your common sense, taking care of yourself. Meeting your basic needs. Needs. Food, clothing, shelter, medical care, quality education. And common sense is what we perceive through our ordinary 5 sense organs that we see, hear, smell, taste, touch. And our instinct, what we feel. If you pay attention to your feelings, they're closer to our subconscious than just our thoughts. Even though the mind is a throne of thought. You need to pay attention to your feelings. Our feelings can be like early warning signals. Early warning signals. Sometimes I repeat stuff because I'm dealing with many people who I think they have a crippled cognition. A crippled cognition. C-O-G-N-I-T-I-O-N. In terms of their perception of reality, their conception of reality, and the action that needs to be taken in the reality. So cognition involves perception, conception, and action. You just can't be a pull on the hill, just think we're all that in the bag of chips, and then we don't do shit. I love Twitter because it's kind of a way where I express myself on Twitter, and then hope that I correct any synapses, and hope that I create neurons or stimulate thought. So these people stop and think, stop and feel. Their being, B-E-I-N-G. I spell things because sometimes I don't pronounce words correctly. I had a brain aneurysm a couple of years ago. I don't want to harp on that, but just so you know. I've had it. I'm not going to hold back shit. I'm not going to live in fear. I'm not going to be living afraid of what others might think about me. Fuck them. They do shit for the revolution. They're irrelevant to what I got to do. I got to be true to myself. True to my core principles, true to who I am as a humane being. I refuse to be a hypocrite. I refuse to be a zombie. I refuse to be a clone. I damn well refuse to be a fucking American. Ugly American. I'm a Chicano. De Aztlán. Here in Sacramento, California, much of the Southwest before the past was Northern Mexico. Now we got that fascist pig Trump kidnapping babies from parents, separating families, and Americans just go on like, you know, as long as it doesn't affect them, they don't want to get out of line. I respect the goodness of America. I know about its original sins. S-I-N-S. S-I-N-S. The original sin of genocide. Against African slaves, the original sin of genocide against the indigenous natives who were here before. I can go on and on, I can spin on different things. I just want to share this from now. Because we utilize what we can, including the right to vote, the power to vote. We got to break out of the mental hold of the Democratic and Republican parties. Be independent. Live as free as you can without fear. Be first and foremost, be a humane being. Humane. Have care, concern, and compassion as a humane being. So, I feel better now. See, when you express yourself, then it's healthy. express yourself, then you can release anxiety. When you express yourself, you can feel more who you are. A major goal of psychoanalysis is to make the subconscious conscious, bring it up to what's deep down that you might hide or repress up to a conscious level. So you can comprehend it, so you can clarify, so you can crystallize your own consciousness. So pray for me in the days to come, times to come. Believe in the power of prayer, whether you're religious or not. But prayer is like heartfelt vibration that resonates out to the galaxies, that resonates out to the cosmos. Cosmos can feel it, can feel that vibration. Study Tesla. Hope y'all did fine. Tomorrow's Friday. Plan to go to my NA meeting and survive the weekend until I get my little allowance next Monday. So know that you're not alone. Others, if you're struggling, I struggle too. Know that if you're worried, I'm worried too. I'm just a man. Man of the people. That's it for now. That's all, folks. Power to the truth. Nada más.